Is this what your current email signature looks like? That is a missed opportunity. In this video, I'm gonna show you step by step how to create an email signature for your acting career that will get more views on your website and your social media. Let's go. Before I show you step by step how to create an email signature, let's first talk about what you should put in it. You of course want to have your name. Now, if you're a multi-hyphenate, it may be useful to have your titles. So maybe you're an actor, producer, founder of this theater company. And next, if you have a website, you can include your website link and the links to your social networks. And you may also have a photo, which is most likely going to be your headshot. Keep in mind, when it comes to your email signature, less is usually more. And when I say more, I mean more eyes on your YouTube channel, your social media, or your website, which is ultimately what you want. Now that we know what goes into that email signature, let's talk about how to create it. Now, there's really two ways you can go with this. You can use an app or a tool to create it, or you can go the do-it-yourself route. And lucky for you, I'm gonna show you both ways today in this video. Now, if you don't wanna mess with tech, you just want an easy plug-and-play solution, then I suggest you use an app or a tool. And the one I suggest to my clients and students is called YStamp. So let's hop into YStamp right now, and I'll show you how to create yours.
So this is YStamp, and it's at YStamp.com. I'll make sure the link is in the description. It is both a free tool and paid tool, but most actors will be completely fine using the free version to create their signature. All you have to do is go right here. And as you can see, this is so super simple. All you have to do is put your information in and it's gonna generate an email signature for you. So let's see how this would work. We're just gonna use my name here. Remember, we talked about what would go in the email signature, your name, maybe your title. If I was an actor producer, especially if you're multi-hyphenate, it might be good to put your different talents here. If you have a website, you would add it here. And as I go here, you can see it's just putting everything right here for us. No design experience needed, right? Now, email is pretty redundant because if I'm emailing somebody, they have my email. Next, I'm gonna add a photo. As an actor, this is obviously going to be a headshot of some sort. Okay. Now you can see here, if you do opt for the free version, they will have a little link to their website, create your own email signature. So by paying the couple dollars a month to upgrade to Pro, you will get a lot of cool features and they will remove that. Let's add some social icons so that we can grow our following one email at a time. Now what we need to do is just add some usernames here. Now just be careful, you do not need to add every single social network that you're on. I'm on Pinterest, but I use it to look up art projects for my daughter. So it's not something I'm going to put on my email signature. Remember, less is more. Send us to the places that you're actively using, where you're creating a positive first impression for your career. We can hit show more here, and you're gonna see all different icons, including IMDb, right? So I am not an actor, I'm a social media coach, but if I was, I could include an IMDb there, right? And there's all sorts of icons here that we could add. Plus, in the Pro account, you could upload your own icons for other casting profiles as well. Pretty cool, right? And I'm gonna show you a tool in a second when we build your own email signature using Gmail that will show you how to create these icons if you wanted to add any extra ones. All right, so we added our details, we added our icons. They also give us a couple free templates that we can choose from. There we go. I'm liking the classic one right now. And if you did upgrade, you can see there are tons of Pro templates here that you can choose from. Then we've got design here. These are Pro features, but you can change the font. So you can play with the shape of your headshot, the size of your headshot, how big you want it compared to everything else. And we can also change the shape and size of our social icons. Keep in mind, if you make your social icons large, that's what our eye is gonna be drawn to. So obviously you'll be driving more traffic to your social media or IMDb versus your website or anything else on the email. And like I said, this is all in the paid version, but pretty cool, right? Now, YStamp also has all other sorts of cool add-ons. You can have a cool sign-off. You can have bigger social buttons. You can add video, which can be very helpful for actors. I've seen actors actually include their reel here. Or if you're really into Instagram, you can have your Instagram grid at the bottom. Just keep in mind, as you add these features, remember what I said, less is usually more. A confused mind always says no, so really, the more you add here, the less people are gonna go to your website and your social media. Keep it simple. What's your goal? What do you want them to do when they go to the bottom of your email signature? Do you wanna grow your social? Do you wanna send people to your website? Do you want people to watch your reel? Well, lead with that, make that the biggest thing, and really pull back on the other design elements. So there you go. Look how simple it is to create an email signature here, guys. So super simple. Well, and like I said, I will include the link in the description below to YStamp.
So now that you know how to use an app to create your email signature, let's talk the do-it-yourself route. I'm gonna show you step-by-step how to create your email signature for free using Gmail. Let's hop in my computer.
To create your own signature, all you have to do is hop into your Gmail account and look for this gear icon here, hit settings, and you'll actually be brought to the page I was already on. And you're gonna scroll down until you see this right here, signature. Now I'm just gonna get rid of my signature for right now so we can build a new one. So this is what you'll be seeing, nothing, right? You're gonna choose your email account that you want it linked to, and then we're gonna start building. So remember, we can add our name. We can add our title if we are a multi-hyphenate. So I'll use the same example I used in YStamp. If you have a website, we can add a website here. We can also play with these texts, make sure it's the color we want. Maybe we want to make our name bold. We can choose from their fonts here. There aren't a lot of them, but that's okay because we know whatever fonts we choose from here, they're gonna look good everywhere online, guys. You don't wanna get fancy here. Use what they give you, okay? Less is more, right? And this is a good size. If we play around too much here, it's either gonna get too small or just way too big. So I like to use normal here. All right, next we can add a photo. So to do that, we're gonna go right here to insert image, and you can either just upload one that you have on your computer, or you can resize it using a tool like Canva. So let me just show you the difference. So I can just upload a headshot here, one I use for my business. But you can see how big it is. We're gonna hit small to resize it. It's fine, but I think we could probably put it in a little frame and make it look a little cooler with a tool called Canva. I use canva.com for so many things, from my header photos for social media, to animated posts, to stories. It's a fantastic tool, and it's free, guys. So we're gonna hit create a design here, and custom dimensions. Now for this picture on my signature, I have it at 300 by 300. We're gonna hit create design. We're gonna go to elements. We're gonna look for frames, and I wanna choose a circle frame, so I'm putting frame circle. Gonna help the search come up. Here you go. I'm looking for one where I can drop a picture in it. And if it has this cloud and sky and green background, it means I can drop a picture into it. So it's gonna take that rectangle picture and turn it into a circle. So to add a picture into this frame, you are gonna hit upload an image, and you're gonna add your picture to this. I already have one on here, so I'm just gonna drag it in here. And if you just hover the picture over, it's gonna drop it into the frame. And you have the ability to resize this however you like it. Remember, this is a small icon, so make yourself a little bigger, right? And look how great that looks. That's gonna look so much better than just the rectangle version I had on there. Okay, we're gonna save this as email signature. Hit file, save. And then this will download it here. Now, I have a pro version, so I have the ability to do a transparent background. If you don't, don't worry. I'm gonna hit download, and it'll be saved to my computer. Let's go back into Gmail and upload this. So I'm gonna get rid of this one because we're gonna put the nicer looking one. We're gonna hit insert image, upload, and we're gonna look for this email signature. That's a little too big, right? Even at that size. So all we have to do is play with these buttons. I go right to small every time. And that looks fantastic, especially for creating it myself, right? So the next thing we need to add are those social icons. And we're gonna do it in the same exact way we just added this photo. We're gonna go into Canva. We're gonna hit create a design. But this time, I want you, let's see if it lets me. No, we're gonna do 40 by 40, because you can see there, I like to have my icons be 30 by 30. Canva only lets us create something 40 by 40. I'll show you how to resize them in a second. So we're doing 40 by 40, create design. And we're gonna go to elements again. And I want you to search for whatever social icons you're going to wanna put in your signature. So I just searched for YouTube. And if I'm moving fast here, guys, don't worry, just hit pause, hit rewind. This video will be here for you whenever you need it. So you can see I dropped in the YouTube icon, and you're gonna wanna use square icons because you want your icons all to be the same size and you want them to fit in this 40 by 40 box here. So pretty much I just took it and I dragged it to the corners. I'm gonna hit YouTube. I'm gonna hit file, save once again. Same thing here. Don't worry if you can't do transparent background, download. This is gonna download on my computer, and then I'm gonna rinse and repeat. I'm gonna go up here and I'm gonna choose Instagram, right? And look what they have. I'm gonna drag it out. Same process, right? Instagram. And I'm gonna hit save. Then I'm gonna hit download. Transparent, if you're able to, download. I already have these saved to my computer, so that's why I'm not actually downloading them. I wanna just quickly walk you through the process. Oops. So you can do this right away. Twitter, and like I said, you're gonna do this for whatever networks you use. What's great is you can get really creative here. Save, same thing, and download. You can get creative here, right? Because look what Canva has here, okay? You are gonna wanna make these square. So if you're gonna do IMDb, you wanna choose the square one. You can play with the colors. Come in here, give it whatever color you want, okay? And do the same thing. So whatever works for you. So we're gonna go back to our email signature. The icons we created are 40 by 40. They're gonna be a little bit big. So let me show you how to quickly resize those. Okay, so to resize this, this one is already size 30 by 30. But what you would do is you would go into the icon you just created. You'd hit the pencil here. You'd hit the resize button here. And yours will say 40 by 40. You are gonna change it to 30 by 30 and it's going to magically resize it. That simple, right? Same thing, you're gonna go into the Twitter one or whatever ones you have, hit the pencil. Hit the resize and change this from 40 to 40 to 30 by 30 like you see here. Same thing for all your icons, so they're all the same size. Okay? All right, so we're back here in our signature. Final steps here, we're inserting our images. I'm gonna lead with YouTube. Okay, and we're just gonna put them in here now. I'll add the hyperlinks in a second. You can see I am inserting it, I'm moving my mouse, I'm adding a space. So there's a little bit of space. I'm going back up to insert image. Like I said, you guys can watch this over and over again. I'm showing you exactly how to do this. So there we go. So the only thing missing now are links. Our website needs to be linked, so we wanna highlight it. We wanna hit link, and there you go. Same thing here, YouTube, we're gonna highlight the icon. We're gonna go up to where it says link, and we're gonna put our YouTube channel link. Now yours may have a bunch of numbers and letters and that's fine. You may not have been able to customize it yet. Same thing, I'm gonna hover, highlight on Twitter. I'm going to link it. Now if you don't know what your social media links are, let me show you. You just go right into the platform. And when you're looking at your profile, right? So I am seeing my feed here, right? So I'm looking at my feed. I'm gonna go up to the browser right here. I'm gonna copy that link. That is the link that goes here. pretty much twitter.com with your username. And the same goes for Instagram. We're going to hover, we're gonna link it. You can go here, you can see I can get my username or my link. And now you can see when I go over them, they are all linked. Pretty cool, right? So once you have done all of those steps, you're happy with this, you've linked everything, you're gonna go to the bottom and hit save. If you don't do that, it's not gonna work. Then I want you to go over here and hit compose. And I want you to send yourself a test, just so you can look at it, you can click into it and see how it works. And this is how it looks. It looks great, right? We just created this in just a couple minutes and you're gonna do the same thing. So I'm emailing this to myself. I'm gonna click on it, and now I can actually go in here, click on the buttons, and make sure that it is going to the right place, including my website. So make sure you come in here after you've created it and send yourself an email and test all the links. Very, very important.
So there you have it, two ways to create your email signature for your acting career for free. Awesome, right? Before you go, hop in the comments below. I wanna hear from you. I wanna know which route you're gonna go. Just type Y stamp or DIY so I know which one you're going to try. I cannot wait to see your email signature in your next email. Your email signature is a fantastic way to grow that following on social media, one email at a time. So make sure you set it up today. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. Until next time, guys, I'll see you on social. Bye.